I'm very excited to announce that Fillout is now in beta for its latest feature, Scheduler. That's right, Fillout is now coming after Calendly and similar scheduling tools, allowing you to build your own events and schedule them directly in Fillout. And the best part is, it's really, really affordable. So if learning more about this amazing new feature is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting, where we help you get the most out of your no-code tools. Fillout is one of our favorite form softwares, and I am really excited to finally announce the fact that they are doing their beta testing for their scheduler feature, allowing us now to start scheduling events directly inside of Fillout and not need some sort of appointment scheduler like Calendly or Acuity. So I'm going to be breaking this down in this video, but before I get into the heart of things, I first want to invite you to join me for some automation training. Automation is that thing that makes no-code so powerful. It allows us to move data from one place to another, update information, change its format. Essentially, we can do all those repetitive, mundane tasks in the background and set them on automatic. I'm going to teach you exactly how to do that in my automation training. Grab it at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. But enough of that. Let's now hop into the heart of the video. And I want to first take our attention to the Fillout scheduling beta. Here we are on the brand new page. If you don't already have an account in Fillout, go ahead and sign up using the link I share with this video. It'll take you right here. If you do already have a Fillout, go ahead and open it up and follow along with me here. So we are going to now be able to create scheduler. And as you see, we can set up all of the different components, you know, the title of the meeting, the duration, where is the meeting going to be held? All of that is going to happen inside of the actual tool itself. We no longer need an account with Calendly or Acuity or some other scheduling tool. And we can now just build this in here. As you can see in the different features here, we've got easy rescheduling and cancellations. You won't be able to double book events because you'll block stuff off. You can meet on your own terms wherever you want to meet, optimizing your day, etc., etc. It's as flexible as a form, as they say here, and you can even include fees in part of this form as well. So if you want to collect money before people book with you, you can integrate with Stripe in order to collect payment and then take them to the next part of your form where they can fill out this information. I'll let you continue to scroll through this page and get all of the different stuff read, but for now, I want to hop into the tool and build one of these live for us here. So I'm going to go right in here and say, yes, let's get started. Let's build our first scheduling example. And inside here, you see I'm taken right to creating a scheduling form. So I can give it a title. I can just say test demo. In full transparency, I've already created one of these. So I've already gone through the integration process. If you have not done that yet, it's very simple. You're just going to tell it your credentials, connect it to your calendar, and there you go. So I've got my test demo here. We set the duration. We can do a custom duration or just set it for 15 minutes. We can also set a meeting location. In this case, I might say, hey, I'm going to give you a phone call, or I want to sync up with my Zoom account. As you can see, I've already integrated that as well. Whatever the setup for you is, wherever you want to host that meeting, you can do so here. And of course, if you don't see the option, you can do a custom. And then lastly, we're going to continue, and this is going to take us to the actual form itself. So it's asking us to name it. Yes, I'm going to keep the name test demo and continue. So the first place my eyes are drawn is up to the top where I've got the different components. This is very similar to every other part of building a fill-out form. If you've ever built a fill-out form, we've got the edit component where we change the form itself. We've got integrations, share, results, and settings. So results is where we can go to see the people who have submitted information. Settings is where we can do some more advanced setup here. Share is where we will go to publish the form and ultimately share or embed this form. And then integrations are where we can connect it to all the different tools we might use in the no-code space. But back here in edit, this is the most important part for this. We can add a description. Let's say this is a secret test. I can also highlight this, embolden the text, use italics, underline, and even include some URLs. So if I want to hyperlink to something, I can do that. Let's go ahead and say done here. And whatever memo we write up here in the description is going to show up right here. Now, we actually do not have a character limit in that description. If we type a lot of text, there will be a little scroll section and people can scroll down and look at all of the text that we've included for this. And we can also change the theme and the feel of the form. So if we want to change the way it looks or feels, we can do that. There are some preset options down here. And if you don't find something that you love, and if you're on a pro plan, you can go to the custom theme and upgrade right there. So back now to the form itself, let's talk about availability. We've gone through the general settings, but now we have to set up our calendar. As you can see, this is where we've synced up with a calendar. So we can change that right here by clicking here and either breaking the connection here or syncing with another calendar inside our account or integrating with another tool. Back to the form now, we can also limit the future bookings. So we can say, hey, look, you can't book this thing 90 days in the future. So maybe only for the next 60 days are you allowed to book. We can also require minimum notice. So you can't book something, let's say, within the next 24 hours. So if I had availability today, tomorrow, you wouldn't be able to get on my calendar until 24 hours from now. We can also include buffer time. So adding before or after bookings, 15, 20 minutes, so that we're not back to back to back. I know how arduous that can be if you're going hard from meeting to meeting. Now, lastly, we can go down to advanced here, and this is where we can select the respondent email, respondent name, also give this an event title. This has a great default setting already. We don't have to give it a name. And then, of course, when are the start time? Do we want to start it every 15 minutes, every 30? Remember, this is a 15-minute event that I'm building, so I might want to start it on the hour and the half hour. And when we look here, we'll see this is exactly what happens in the form. People have now the option to sync up with us here, pick a time, and the very next part of that form, they're going to be asked for their name and email. They can then schedule the event and it will show up on our calendar. Any events that are already on our calendar and blocked out will not show up as available here on the times that are showing in the scheduler. Now, this is very similar to Calendly and Acuity. You know, other tools have been out there for a long time. So what makes this one so special? In my opinion, it's how they are pricing this, and you are going to absolutely love this. Before I move into this, though, I want to publish this form, and I'm going to go into the next component here in my account. So if I'm just inside of Fillout, the first place I need to go to look at all my scheduling forms is to hit the tab up here at the top. It used to be that this was all, you know, forms, and we had the workspaces on the left. Well, we have this new section here that allows us to get right into the scheduling forms. So right here, we can see all the different forms. And if other people on our team had been made available here and had synced up with their calendars, we would see their information here as well. So any events as an admin user in our Fillout account, all admin users will be able to see all of the events that are here. Now, that's very different from how other folks will use the tool. So let's talk quickly about the new team members. As you can see, we have four people here who are all admin users, but I can invite a member and I don't have to make them admin. This is a new feature that Fillout has just rolled out in conjunction with the scheduler. And the reason for this is, as you see, admins have access to view and edit all the things, right? All workspaces, all settings. But a basic user can create their own forms, their own scheduling links, but they cannot edit anyone else's stuff. So this is so important. So I can go ahead and invite everyone on my team. And now let's talk about Fillout's pricing. This is gonna blow you away. Every user that you add does not cost you anything else. Your account at Fillout is not a per user fee. Your account is whatever level settings you're on, full stop. That's the end of the story. What this means is that you can have one Fillout account, as many different users as you want, using Scheduler, and you will not incur additional charges for those users. I don't know about you, but I'm really excited about this because we use Calendly internally and I'm paying $12 to $20 a month per Calendly user, and that stacks up over time. It's gonna save literally thousands of dollars for our company every month, and I guess probably yours as well. So if you're already using a tool like Calendly or Acuity, this is gonna really save you some money because it's not going to incur additional charges for every user. So go ahead and add all your basic users, email addresses right here. And then once they've been invited, you'll be able to see them here. And if they've connected their calendar, you will see it connected with this logo. So here are the other folks on my team. You can see they have not connected their calendars yet, but once they do, it will show up here. Now, as a next step, I can create, because I'm an admin, I can create those events with people in their calendars. So it's actually going to ask me here, what calendar are you connecting to in this particular setup? So when I create this event, I get to pick whose calendar this gets synced up to, depending on how many different folks have synced or integrated their calendars already. I really encourage you to give this a try. There are new components, new features being released constantly now as they're working through the beta process. So if you have feedback, I encourage you to reach out to Fillout as well and let them know so that they can build the best tool for you. I know we went pretty quick here, so drop questions you have below. And in the meantime, keep on building.